started.
Okay, so listen up, guys. Listen up. Learning target one said that you can determine whether a chemical reaction occurred based on the five signs of chemical reaction. Learning target two says that you can identify a chemical reaction according to type. So you can determine whether it is synthesis, decomposition, single displacement, double displacement, or combustion. Over the next 3 days, we're going to be doing learning targets 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and they all start off the same one. Okay, today we're going to be doing learning targets 3 and 4. We are going to be predicting products of chemical reactions. Okay, I'll focus it. Okay, we're predicting products. So today, we're starting off with learning target 3, which is predicting the products of a synthesis reaction. Okay, predicting products of a synthesis reaction. We follow the same two steps every time we predict products of a synthesis reaction. Okay, step one is going to be find the charges of the reactants. Remember that charges are oxidation numbers, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0. Okay, then our second step is going to be to make a neutral product. What does neutral mean?
It's
no charge. Okay, that its total equals 0. So this is why you need your periodic table, because you need to be able to determine the charges of the reactants. So for example, if I give you a problem that says Na plus Cl2, so sodium plus chlorine, what does that make? So step one is going to be to find the charges. It is going to make salt, but let's find out what the formula is going to be, right? So what's the charge on sodium?
Plus one.
And we're just going to ignore this little subscript here, guys. And we're going to just say, okay, my element is chlorine. And what's the charge on chlorine?
Negative one.
So do plus one and minus one. Does that total 0?
Yes.
Yep, it does. And so I don't need any more of either of them. So my product is just
NaCl.
NaCl.
Wait, but since you have two of them, does that matter?
So this is not a balanced equation. And we're just going to go with that for now, because we still haven't talked about balancing chemical equations. Eventually, we would have to account for that, but today, we're not worried about that. All we're looking at is the charge of the individual element, and we don't need to worry about those subscripts, okay? Okay, what if I give you, let's do another one. What if I give you aluminum plus sulfur? Aluminum plus sulfur, what is that going to make? So step one, find the charges of the reactants.
It's 3.
Okay, so aluminum is plus 3, Ernest? Okay, and what's sulfur?
Negative 2.
Okay, -2. So do plus 3 and minus 2. Do they total 0?
Mm-mm.
No, so what is my least common multiple there?
6.
So how many more aluminums do I need?
One.
So if I throw another one on there, how much positive do I have now?
6.
Okay. Throw another sulfur on there.
No.
4. No? Put another one?
Yes.
Yeah.
6.
Okay,
6.
So how much negative do I have now?
3. 6.
So I have +6, -6. And so what do I write?
Al.
2.
2, because I have 2 of them.
S.
3. Because I have 3 of them. That's it. Okay, let me give you guys one more. Hang on, I just want to check something. Calcium plus nitrogen. Calcium plus nitrogen. up so you can see it. Try this one on your own quick, okay? Find your charges, make it total zero. What's the charge on calcium?
Plus two.
Plus two. What's the charge on nitrogen?
Minus three.
Minus three. How many calciums do I need?
Three.
I need three calciums total, and how many nitrogens do I need?
Two.
Ca3N2. Anytime you have a synthesis reaction, you are taking two substances and putting them together. These are the steps you're going to follow. Questions so far? Can I move on to decomposition? Yes?
Yes.
Okay. So learning target four is predict the products of a decomposition reaction. And with decomposition, remember that this is where we are taking one thing and breaking it down into simpler substances. So our steps for a decomposition reaction. First, we are going to break apart the reactant. And a key thing here is that we are going to ignore any subscripts that are on there. The subscripts, remember, those are the little numbers at the bottom. They don't matter right now. And then second, we are going to determine anything that needs to be diatomic. What does the prefix di mean?
Two.
Two. So diatomic means
two atomics.
So two
atoms.
Yeah, two atoms. And so we're going to determine the diatomics. And these you guys will hear me refer to often as the super seven. Why? Because there are seven elements that need to be diatomic. They need to occur as two atoms, because they are not stable by themselves. So seven elements on the periodic table have to have a little two beside them in order to be stable. It means that I take two atoms, bond them together, and that makes them happy. So on your periodic table, I would strongly suggest that you mark these down. The nice thing about them is that, you guys, who's always the rule breaker on the periodic table?
Hydrogen.
So you guys, hydrogen is one of our super seven, okay, right here. So I put a little box around him. He is one of the super seven. And then there are six other elements that need to be diatomic. And notice when I put a box around them, what do they form?
A seven.
A seven. So nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Whenever you have one of those elements by itself, it's going to have a little two beside it. It is going to be diatomic. So if you have oxygen, it's not just O, it's O2. And I'm sure you guys have seen that before, that oxygen, like the oxygen in our atmosphere, isn't just O, it's O2. Okay, so any of these seven elements, if they are by themselves, have to have the little subscript two beside them. If you don't have your periodic table, I would absolutely make a note in your notebook of which elements need to be diatomic. Hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Okay, hopefully you have these down or a neighbor has them down. Let's go back and do some samples. Okay, all right guys, what if I give you potassium fluoride, K? KF. So the first thing I do is I break it apart. So I say K plus F. And then I look at these and I say, are either of these super sevens? Do either of these need to be diatomic?
Yeah.
Is potassium a super seven?
No.
No, it is not. Is fluorine a super seven?
Yes.
Yes, it is. So what am I going to put by him?
Two.
A little two. And then I'm done. That's it. That's it. Yes.
What if it's not a super seven?
If it's not a super seven, then I leave it alone. Okay. So let's look at another one, guys. Okay. What if I give you something like iron 2 phosphide, Fe3P2, Fe3P2. So step one says break apart the reactants, ignore the subscripts. So this little 3 and this little 2, they don't matter. I don't pay attention to them. I break it apart and I say Fe plus P. And then I look at these and I say, does iron need anything?
No.
No. Does phosphorus need anything?
No.
So I'm done. Fe plus P. In a minute. Okay, one more. What if I give you HBr, hydrogen bromide?
Oh, I could cut this one.
And give everybody a chance, quick. So, Aiden, what do I do first?
You do H plus Br.
So break it apart into H plus Br.
And then you see the H isn't one of the super seven.
That it is or it isn't?
Isn't.
Really? Are you sure?
It is.
Well, I don't see no H.
Hydrogen.
Remember, he's the exception. So do I need anything on here?
Two.
You get two on both of them.
So I need a two on that one, and then you're right, I do need it on both of them. So a two on this one as well.
I realize there's only six there.
Yep. Okay, what questions do you currently have?
None.
None?
None.
Say it.
Why do super seven?
The super seven have a two on them because they're not stable by themselves. And so in order to be happy, they bond with another atom of the same element that makes them happy. And so that's why they occur that way. I can draw you some pictures to show you the electrons being shared and whatnot. But I'll let everybody get started and then I'll chat with you about that. Okay? So you guys are going to get two sheets today. You're going to get a full sheet. And then you're going to get a half sheet. And you are going to write on both of these sheets. Belle, will you please hit the stop recording button?